It's just after sunrise here at Round Rock Donuts, and I'm here to chow down on a true Texas tradition. Yeah, that's right, donuts. You see, because of a wave of immigrants from Eastern Europe in the early 19th century, Texas has one of the richest donut traditions in the country. And one of the best and biggest you're likely to find in this nation is found right here, Round Rock Donuts.
For over 70 years, Round Rock Donuts have been made carefully by hand, using farm-fresh eggs and yeast. These aren't the machine-made baking soda and shortening donuts you'd find in a chain. And one variety isn't just delectable, it's huge. Behold, the Texas Donut.
You gotta explain to me how this bad boy came into being. Was there like a nuclear experiment and a regular donut landed? Or is this like a regular donut that you make angry and it gets really big?
All of the above.
All of the above. So it's both a radioactive, right. Incredible Hulk, right. Anger-activated yeah. Pastry. I love it.
This sugary behemoth is 14 inches in diameter and weighs an astonishing 2 pounds.
Wow. Wow. Gentlemen, to Round Rock.
Round Rock.
I have to make this Texas bad boy for myself. 12-year Round Rock veteran Polo Garcia agrees to show me how. And since making a Round Rock donut of any size is such an art form, we start with a batch of the basics.
All right, so this is already proofed. So that's that just the yeast has had a chance to rise and aerate the dough, okay?
That's right. Give it the body. Ooh. See?
I know you sprayed me a little bit. I'm not so happy at you, but all right. Can
Let's
I do this
again.
One of these? So I just shake it like a bed sheet.
That's right. We're gonna move some of
I just tore it. Oh, I'm lame.
Right. Now we're gonna cut it.
Oh, this thing looks so cool, a donut cutter. And that also makes the donut holes, too.
That's right.
Awesome. There you go. I've been working on the donuts all the livelong day.
After Polo schools me in picking out donut holes,
I want you to use your fingers.
How do you do it so fast? You really go. You do a double time hard. Oh yeah, I learned from the master. Look at this.
It's time to hit the fryer.
Do it. Fry that donut.
The donuts cook about a minute on each side until they need a flip. And since hot oil is involved, Polo applies a special technique.
Let's do it.
Okay, ooh, God, you are fast, my man. Hup, hip, ho, hup, hip, ho, hup.
Thank you, Aston! See you next tour!
Then I pour on Round Rock's decadent orange glaze. It's also handmade, using vanilla, butter, sugar, and a few secret ingredients.
Born to do it, born to do it. Fresh from the fryer, newly iced by me and Polo. It's like caramel. You think you're taking this huge bite and it all shrinks and melts in your mouth. It's like this little bit of candy, but it's got the chewiness of a cake.
After eating the best, the only thing left to do is make the biggest. And forget fancy donut cutters. To make a Texas donut, you need a bucket.
Right now, I'm cutting one of these absolute single biggest donuts that you can buy in the world. And it's awesome.
It's about 2 pounds.
That's one donut with as much dough to make a dozen. Wow, look at that. That's unbelievable, really, how big it is. It's like a snowshoe. And what's also great is like how like it really forms a nice hard crust. You can even hear it. Sorry, I just broke the donut. I'm gonna stop.
After some more glazing, I ice my way into Round Rock history.
I just branded me a donut. Polo, I'll see you down a trail, partner.
I'll see you too.
Y'all come back now, yeah?
My never-ending quest for barbecue bliss has led me right here to the Salt Lick in Driftwood, right outside Austin, Texas. This place is said to have some of the best brisket, ribs, and sausage in the Lone Star State. And today, they're enjoyed by both Rebels and Yankees, and Red Sox. Because when it comes to barbecue, even they have good taste. While all the mouth-watering meats on Salt Lick's menu are exceptional, one thing in this place is a true Texas treasure. The open pit.
Oh my God, an open pit. An open pit. You can't find these anywhere anymore. Not just in Texas, anywhere. Some states don't even allow them.
That is how you get proper Texas Hill Country barbecue. Can't fake it.
Hill Country barbecue centers on brisket, a cut of beef that requires hours of slow cooking to make it tender enough to eat. Before a brisket at Salt Lick hits the pit, A dry rub is generously applied.
This is good. I feel like I'm in massage school. Oh, yeah, you have a little bit of tension right along the fat.
There you go.
A little bit of tension.
Owner Scott Roberts, the current curator of his family's 150-year-old recipes, shows me Salt Lick's take on Hill Country tradition.
All right, I want to see this thing cooked.
Sure, come on.
Let's do it. This is the best part. All right. It's incredible. Every single protein, every single meat, it imparts such a different smoke and such a different smell. And when they all are together, it's like paradise.
The foundation for this aromatic nirvana is the wood that fuels the fire. And Salt Lick is very particular about what they use.
This kind of oak is the heaviest of all the oak family, which means it's the densest. It's the denseness of the wood that I believe that creates a smoke that's different than any other oak smoke.
Salt Lick keeps a bucket of wet pecan shells that help keep the fire at bay and add more flavor to the smoke. The oak and pecan-infused meat will tell you when it's ready to flip with a pop. There's no set time.
Oh, look at those scoring marks.
And while most Hill Country joints keep their meat dry, Salt Lick bastes theirs in a sauce with 32 individual spices.
Because it has such a high sugar vinegar content, it caramelizes on the outside of the meat.
Oh, lovely.
And then it also drips down and hits the coals, and then it flares up, and then that smoke. And then that comes back up into it, too.
And just slap it on?
Just slap it on.
Yes, sir. My pleasure.
The trifecta of flavor in the smoke, dense oak, pecan, and spices, makes the finished brisket a masterpiece.
Good.
You're a genius. It melts. I know everyone says that it melts in your mouth. It literally melts. You can feel it. The fat renders the second it touches your tongue.
Scott lets me have a taste of a burnt end, a smoky brisket trimming that's too intense for some.
This is called burnt ends, and some places make like baked beans with burnt ends and stuff like that. And people are like, oh, burnt food, not good for you. Absolutely not. There's just a char on it. You can see the meat is perfect, still gets that gorgeous smoke ring. This is a private moment, man. That's fantastic. I'm gonna tell you point blank, and you guys see me eat a lot of stuff, one of the best things I've ever eaten. It's like where all the flavor seems to have collected. Unbelievable.